Hey Georgie, this is Ryan with TrendLizard.com. I hope you're doing well. Hope you survived today's interesting stock market session. Thanks for sending me an email. I'm going to take a look at three stocks for you today. We're going to take a look at Advanced Micro Devices, ticker AMD. We're going to take a look at NIO, ticker NIO. And then we're going to wrap it up with a look at Fluidigm, ticker FLDM. All three very interesting stocks. I can see why you want me to take a look at them for you. I know I've taken a look at least two of these for you before. So a little bit of it is a review, but we're going to start from the top anyway. Starting with AMD. It was incepted back in 1983 and, as you know, has been through a large, huge swing-type pattern for several decades, looks like three decades there, before recording a low finally in 2015 and taking off to the upside. So this entire choppy back-and-forth mess here is just one big counter-trend move. The only thing we really care about is the advance that started in 2015 to the upside. Now, this is a trendy move, has to be a trendy move. It's broken out to new highs, more than doubled basically where it was back in 2000. So everything tells us this is a trendy move. And what do we know about trendy moves? They play out in five-wave patterns. So bottom line, we're looking for the formation of a five-wave pattern to the upside off the 2015 low. So let's go ahead and take a look at that move and see what we can find. So here it is. The move started in 2015. Very obvious. First wave ended here in 2017. Had a large second wave pullback into the 2018 low. And since then, it's been in a large third wave advance that is not yet over. During that time, off the 2018 low, we've had really one substantial pullback, and that was in late 2018. Otherwise, it's been on the up and up. There is some concern to think that maybe it is starting a larger corrective pullback at this time, but the trend is still up, and in that respect, you have to remain bullish. We can see some larger counter trend pullbacks, but again, until we see the formation of a larger five-wave advance of that 2015 low, higher prices have to be expected. So let's go ahead and just drive in on what's happened off the 2018 low. This is it, and more or less, this is just a way to show you the details of every up leg and why I've counted it how I have. Now here's the concern, really. If you look at the advance off that 2018 low, you can see in green this 1, 2, 3, 4 five-wave pattern fairly clear that looks like it could be a completed five-wave move. And then if you look at that advance off the 2020 low, again, 1, 2, 3, 4 five-wave move. So you have these upside patterns that look like they're completing, upside five-wave patterns that look like they're completing. And as we drive in here, we see and this is just a little more detail on what's happened off that 2020 low. We can see what's happened is basically since December, AMD has leveled out and started to trade sideways to down. So that's the concern here, is that we've completed five-wave patterns to the upside if we jump back to this chart, and that we've started the larger fourth-wave pullback basically to offset this second-wave pullback that happened back in 2018. You can kind of see the damage that that guy did, the time frame it took. So we might have something similar that we're dealing with here. This yellow area that you can see basically from say 47 to about 67 or so represents a Fibonacci retracement of this entire third wave advance here. So if there is a target to be had, it would be down into this yellow area. Another thing we look for is for the fourth of the previous third wave to be tested, which resides around 75. These are all areas that could potentially be tested as this fourth wave pullback continues. So if we drive in a little bit closer, this takes a look at all that back and forth action that's happened since December. It's weakened pretty good over the past week or so. It is close to setting a new low for this choppy down move. The temptation is to label it as a counter trend move, as it should be, right? If it's a fourth wave pullback, it should be a counter trend move. But I'm not going to label this move yet because it could go either way. You see, you could say A, B, C, okay, it's a three-wave move, or you could say this is the first leg counter trend move here, and then it's heading lower from there. So we don't want to judge this down move too soon. It does look like a counter trend move, but we'll let it develop. A move above 94 at any point would be a pretty clear sign that it is in fact a counter trend move and that higher prices are coming. But I think you need to wait and allow this fourth wave pullback to do its thing. Expect it to continue over up overall, but I think you do have to expect sideways to lower prices in the midterm as we get a larger counter trend pullback for a fourth wave. Once we get it, ideally with a test in this yellow support area, we'll be looking for the uptrend to resume from there. So there is AMD. Let's go ahead and shift our focus to NIO now, obviously the EV company. It had a bad day today as well, like so many things did. But still, it appears to be in a larger fourth wave pullback, and I'll show you why as we dive in here. I was incepted back in 2018. Not much going on until 2020. Basically, ever since 2020, it's been in this huge advance. Going from under 5 to above 65. It's down to 50 after today. Larger pullback, obviously, but still on the up and up, still looking for higher prices overall on NIO. Let's go ahead and drive in a little bit, take a closer look at price action. Here's what's happened in 2020. First, second wave down, and then we appear to be in the development of a third wave advance. That's not yet over, but still getting closer as we appear to be in the fourth wave of that third wave advance. So let's go ahead and drive in one more time. This takes a look at more proximate action here in 2020, late 2020 and early 2021. The real interest here is what's happened off the 2021 high. It's put a high in, it looks like, the first week of January. Since then, it's been trending lower, particularly over the last eight sessions or so to the downside. But if we take a closer look at that down move, so far this looks like a counter trend move. You have the A wave here, you have a B wave recovery into February's high, and then a sharper down leg here. This sharper down leg appears to be a C wave. The extent and time that it took for this move here to play out looks more like a B wave. All of this stuff fits more of the profile of a counter trend pullback, not the start of a new downtrend. That said, we would still love to see NIO show some signs of a low and reverse up before we do anything too aggressive here. A move above 59.50, while it's kind of far away after what's happened recently, would be a really good sign that this is in fact a counter trend move and that the trend has turned back to the upside. But if you can get any kind of trendy action to the upside off of this sharp down move that's happening here, it'd be worth considering a buy just based on the clear three-wave nature of this move. So if we step out again, this three-wave move appears to be a fourth-wave pullback within an ongoing third-wave advance. So again, kind of like AMD, we see the potential for lower levels in a larger counter-trend move, but overall, the trend is up, and with NIO, a move above 59.50 or trendy price action to the upside would be a pretty good indication that this ABC pullback is over. So one more, Fluidigm, FLDM. I haven't looked at this one for you before. It is actually on one of my watch lists, so I was glad you made me take a closer look at it, and that's what I did here. It was incepted back in 2011. 2013, early 2014, had a great run, went from about 1250 up to about 50, and then it gave it all back. It went on a very big decline, basically starting from 2014 down to the 2020 low. It gave us a five-wave decline to the downside, so nothing to love about that, but I suppose that needs some context because maybe this ended the downtrend and maybe a new uptrend is starting now, or maybe at the least you're getting a counter-trend recovery, one that's going to correct this big five-wave decline. So there's no harm in wanting to know if Fluidigm is worth a trade here. It does appear that this five-wave move completed here. The question is, how tradable is this recovery effort that has emerged off of the 2020 low? So let's go ahead and zoom in on that. Before we do, note that a Fibonacci retracement of this five-wave decline happens in the 20 to about 31 area here. So if we're just getting a correction of this five-wave decline, that's not a bad target. So that's something to keep in mind as things develop. So let's go ahead and zoom in and look at the 2020 recovery here. This is it off of March's low, and it does look like a five-wave move to the upside. It was a little slow starting, but then it looks like you had a extended fifth-wave advance to the upside that spiked higher in August. Unfortunately, it reversed just as quickly, gave it back, retraced almost perfectly 61.8% of this upleg right away. Since then, it has found support at that level multiple times. It is right there at the end of the day today. So clearly, it hasn't been able to bounce yet off that level, but that level has also provided some level of support, so you can look at it both ways. Kind of need to see what happens with Fluidigm here to see if it's a real buying opportunity. That's why it's just on one of my watch lists and not in my portfolio at this time, but it is worth watching. The concern is, what's going to happen next? I mean, if you get a C wave down that moves much below where these lows have already been established, you start getting to the point that you're retracing too much of this up leg for us to really strongly consider this the start of a new trend. So if it moves much lower than here, say below 450 in that area, I'd have a tough time buying it. That would just be too deep of a retracement for me to be interested in buying it or thinking that this is the start of a new trend. I would think more likely that this is just a counter trend recovery, which is harder to trade because it can trade all over the place, can give us triangles, it can give us triple or double corrections, it can do so many different things. That's why I try to keep my trading to only trading trendy moves, just because they're more predictable. They're five-wave moves, that's all they are, so you always know what they're going to do. So anyway, we'll watch this pullback, we'll see what happens here. If it moves much lower, I wouldn't trade it. If it doesn't move that much lower and turns back up and starts giving you trendy upside movement, or if at any point there's a reason to think that this is just one counter trend pullback here ahead of further strength, it could be bought. And a move above 975 would be a good indication that this is a counter trend move and that you're getting at least one more five wave advance to the upside. And given the size of this one off the 2020 low, it's probably a pretty worthy endeavor to participate in. So it would be worth looking at. But again, I need to see more from all three of these guys, some proof that the pullback that's happening right now is over before considering trading them. So, Georgie, I hope that's helpful. Have a wonderful evening. This is Ryan from TrendLizard.com. Y'all have a great evening as well, and we'll talk to you again soon. Take care.